And then if Sunday night's okay, we're going to do something. We have something planned in Anaheim, I think, on Sunday.
Well, brother, you can come anytime you want to. We're what's called a homeless shelter, and we're here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Hammy, why don't you get another one of those batteries? Because I think this one will. And we're doing a live television show right now. We have our studio here. We'll do some live broadcasts with you when you get here. But just so I know how to plan a little bit for myself, when do you think you'd come in? What, late Saturday?
Yeah, late Saturday night. That's okay.
That's fine. You come in, we'll put you down, let you crash. Up here. Okay. Looks like we've got a fresh battery and ripping and raring to go. Now, your name is Isaac, and the name of the group is The Extreme Tour, and we'll check that out a little later. And if in the meantime you would like to find out more about us, just go to your laptop or your iPad or wherever you can go to get the internet, and go to The Wiley, W-I-L-E-Y, Drake Show, The Wiley Drake Show.
Okay.
It is up there right now on the internet around the world, and it will be in the archives a little later. You can see it later if you'd like. And we'd love to do, we can do shows here anytime, night or day. So you guys come on in and get here. You know, whenever you get here, and we'll put you up, bed you down, then we'll have breakfast. We'll let you, won't get you up too early tomorrow, let you have breakfast. And,
yeah.
And then.
Will that be on Sunday?
I'm sorry?
On Sunday?
Yeah, that'd be fine. And if you want to attend.
We'd like to come late Saturday, if it's late on Saturday.
That'd be fine.
And, is there a church that meets there on Sunday? Because we go.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have several. We have several that meet here on Sunday.
Okay.
We meet here on Sunday. We have Sunday school at 9:45.
Okay.
And then we have our worship service at 11. And you're welcome to participate in those. They're live on television as well. We broadcast it. And if you guys would like to perform, you're welcome to. You certainly don't have to. But if you
we're always in. You know, basically what we do is we do outreaches, but we also, you know, churches usually host us and kind of use us to hold an outreach because that's what we're kind of prepared and trained to do is like reach people who would never go to church, like counterculture, street kids, whatever. And
let me just tell you what we have here. We are a traditional Southern Baptist church in one respect. But we have a shelter here. We shelter about 60 people every night.
Mm-hmm.
And and we have a dormitory. They sleep here. We won't put you in the homeless dormitory. We'll put you down in what we call Ground Zero, which is our youth room. And and then if you guys want to perform Sunday morning, we'll have a service at 11. We'd love to have you perform and share your testimony and share about your ministry. And that will be on TV, and we'll do some other things while you're here as well. We are an outreach church. I've been here 27 years, so you can imagine I'm an old guy. And the Lord's really blessed us. We're close to Hollywood, and close by to LA. So, give me a phone number for you.
Okay, are you ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's 951.
Okay.
834.
Okay.
2738.
Let me read back what I wrote down. 951-834-2738. Your name is Isaac. And we'll look for you coming in late Saturday night. And
we won't be in the way on Sunday then if we're there Saturday night.
Oh, no, absolutely not. We'd love to have you come. Okay. We'd love to provide a place for you to sort of camp out.
Okay, great.
And you can stay.
If we could go out and come back, I don't know if that would be okay on Sunday night. We would leave Monday morning.
Absolutely. Okay? You can do it, brother. Awesome. You just make yourself at home. Okay. If you can attend church with us, we have church Sunday morning, Sunday night. And if you could participate in those, that's fine. If you can't, you have to leave. That's okay as well. I'll be here when you come in. Do you any idea about how late you'll be? I mean, will it be midnight or after? Or?
I bet you midnight sounds about right because we're going to be about half an hour away.
Okay.
And the show we're doing, I'd say around about midnight.
Okay, where are you doing a show?
It's going to be in Bellflower.
Well, you're real close to Bellflower. We're just down the freeway, about three off ramps from Bellflower. Where are you going to be?
Okay. We'll probably be at the Angel City Cafe. It's not the kind of show we normally do.
I know the place. We've been there before.
Yeah. Okay, great. Yeah. We're just going to be there being part of an event that's already going on. It's not actually an Extreme Tour event, but we wanted to pass through, and we're doing something in Anaheim probably on Sunday, so I wanted to make sure that we had
Well, you can.
It's really great.
Yeah, you can stay here. Now, the name of that place is what cafe?
The Angel City Cafe.
I'm sorry?
The Angel City Cafe.
Angel City, yeah.
Yeah.
And what time? And that's Angel City Cafe, and that's in Bellflower, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I don't know how late it goes. It might go really late.
Well, I tell you what. I or maybe myself, I might bring somebody with me. We might try to come over there and see you guys over there.
Okay. Although that event really isn't, it's us and a bunch of other artists, and I think we're just going to be at the end. Like, I think we're going on at 9:30 to 10 o'clock.
Okay.
And then I think there might be more after that. I'm not really sure, but they told us just that if we come out, we can be part of it and just have something to do, you know, be part of it. If not, we're just going on for like half an hour and,
do you have a contact name of somebody there? I've sort of lost touch with those guys.
I don't really know the people who work there, but there's another guy who does a lot of events there. He's not part of the venue, but he works a lot of times to put on shows there.
Okay.
And he's the one who told me about it, and he's a rapper. He's called Happy Z, but I don't remember his real name off the top of my head.
That's okay. That's okay. No problem. Well,
yeah.
I'll try to. Do you happen to have their phone number with you?
The guy I was just telling you about?
Well, the Angel Cafe. Angel City.
No, I don't, but I can get it when we go down there. Or I can probably just find it online.
Yeah. But what we'll try to come. We'll see. We'll figure out. I'll check with them, find out what time their thing starts. They usually start pretty early, I think. Yeah, and we may see you there. Depends on what's going on here. Our schedule has a way of getting pretty busy, but I don't have. Well, let's see. No, that's I've got an. I can't come over there Saturday night. I've got an event, event I've got to go to on Saturday night.
Yeah.
But I'll be back here early. I'll be back before you guys would get here, and we might even come by over there. What time are you on? 9:30.
I think we're going at 9 o'clock until 9:30.
9 to 9:30. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I might be able to make it there by then. If not, we're just a couple of off ramp down the freeway. Have you got our street address?
Yeah, she gave it to me. It's in Bueno Park.
Yeah, on 6801 Western Avenue.
Okay, I'll double check it, but I think she gave us that address.
And if you have any questions, if you have any questions, call me on this number. I'll be glad to help you.
Oh, that's fantastic, and I'm guessing that there's a shower there, too?
Oh, yeah, we got showers and everything.
Oh, perfect. Okay, that's wonderful. You guys are an answer to prayer. It really helps us. I'm glad to have met you. I can't wait to meet you guys in person in a few days.
Well, we're looking forward to it, so we'll see you in here Saturday night sometimes. I'm not sure what time I'll get back. I've got a meeting to go to, and I'm not sure what time I'll get back, but... Yeah, do we have your permission to put up a small clip on your band?
Sure.
Okay, well, the reason I'm saying is that we just need to ask for permission to put it up. We can pull something down from YouTube just so we have your permission.
Sure, yeah. Find something that's from the Extreme Tour Ministry.
Yeah, and we'll be showing that. We'll show that later or tomorrow or next day, you know. After the show, we'll pull it down. And we'll promote the fact that Extreme Tour is going to be at Wiley World. And so we'll see you guys Saturday night and then Sunday morning. And then, but you're bailing out on Sunday, right?
It would be Monday morning.
Monday morning. Okay. So you need to stay Saturday night and Sunday night.
Yeah, that's okay.
That's fine. You can stay as long as you want to.
Oh, I love it. You guys are amazing. Thank you.
Well, no, you know, after a couple of months, we'd probably get tired of you. But
yeah, we could just move in. Okay.
Monday morning,
we'd be heading to Temecula.
Oh, okay.
We're doing a big state park event.
Okay, I know exactly where that was at. We were just down there recently with the border problem.
Oh, right, yeah. I've been out of town for the last several months, but I'm from Marietta myself.
Well, we went to Marietta two or three different times. Almost got arrested there. But,
wow.
But we were very active. We went down there and did a live broadcast and did a lot of fun stuff and fought the illegal immigrants and stood up with the people that stood against them. So, all right, well, we'll see you Saturday night then, whenever you get here, and then you can bed down. We'll have breakfast, you know, you can get the shower and then you can have breakfast the next morning and be in the service at 11 if you want to. And
yeah, we will. We always make it a point to go.
Yeah, okay. We'll start telling our people. We'll tell our people, and we'll try to build a little crowd for you.
All right, love it. Thank you so much.
All right, Isaac. Thank you so much. God bless you. If we don't see you before, we'll see you Saturday night.
Okay, sounds great. See you then.
All right. Okay. Bye-bye. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's Wiley World in action. Here's a group called Extreme Tour. And they're probably wild as crazy. I'm only kidding. But anyway, that was Isaac. And we'll check them out a little later after the show. But ladies and gentlemen, live right here at Wiley World, Saturday and Sunday, the Extreme Tour. And Brother Jaime will put something together. We'll put together a little flyer and put it up on the internet. And is that Brother Peter out there?
It is.
Brother Peter. Peter.
Peter.
Got his headset on. Can't hear nothing. Throw something at him. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is live TV. I'm telling you, folks, we do live TV. And when Peter gets in here, if he ever gets here, Peter's getting old and slow, and it takes him a while to get here.
I'm a mess.
Okay, wait a minute. What are you doing?
He wants to put a good shirt on.
No, that's okay. No, we're not going to put him on the TV.
I don't trash.
He's a trash man.
I'm a trash
man. That's okay. Sit down, Peter.
I want to say hello to our listening audience on Crusade Radio, as well as the Congressional Prayer Conference on Washington, D.C. TV.
All right. And now, the reason I brought you in here was not to let you run on and talk and everything, but...
But I had to say hello to the audience.
But you had to say hello to the audience, and Brother Jaime is going to get you on the camera there, I believe.
If he has to.
Did you have to?
Jaime didn't want to put you on the TV because you look like a homeless person.
Right, but I wear many hats, and one of them is to take care of the trash, and that's what I've been doing.
All right. I'm going to give you a new job. I'm going to double your salary.
Okay.
And give you a new job. I do this all the time around here with people.
Well, I'm just excited.
But they always remind me that double nothing is still nothing.
Right.
We just got a call on the telephone from a young fellow by the name of Isaac. And Isaac is a leader and a worker with a group called the Extreme Tour.
Mm.
And they're a music group, and they go around and perform. And guess where they go lots of times? They go to outreach areas. They go to homeless shelters. They go to the park. And they're going, I don't know if you went with us or not, but we went over to a place right over here in Bellflower that was called, what's the name of it? I've forgotten it again. The Angel City Cafe.
I believe I've heard of that.
It's a cafe to witness to people on the street. And it's a cafe. It's an old bar, basically, that they shut down the bar and opened up a cafe. And it's Angel City Cafe.
Yes, I know where it's at.
I think it's on Bellflower Boulevard.
Exactly. It's on Bellflower Boulevard.
Anyway.
And it's near a great restaurant called Chris and Fitz.
Yeah. Anyway, we went over there not too long ago, and we did a live TV show. We had, remember Aaron Schwartzbart?
Yes, I do.
Okay, he's the guy that has the Music Street video.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he went over there and performed, and we went with him, and we did a live TV show. And we had a great time at the Angel City Cafe.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going over there on Saturday night, but I can't get there till late. They're going to be performing somewhere around 10 o'clock, 10:30. And so I've got to go to another meeting. Then we're going to go over there, right over here in Bellflower.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to go over and watch Extreme Tour. And then when they get through playing about midnight, guess where they're staying? Guess
they're going to stay
they're
here.
They're coming to Wiley World.
Southern Baptist Church and Masonic Fellowship.
And they're coming. That's right. They're coming to Wiley World.
To Wiley World.
And they'll be here Saturday night and Sunday night, and they'll be performing.
Oh, they're going to love it here.
They'll be performing with us and for us on Sunday morning.
Well, if I could just state for the record, I am your valet. I'm the studio valet.
Okay.
Make sure.
All right. And make sure.
They got bottled water.
Okay. All right. They're going to be coming in. There's about 10 or 15 of them.
I think it's great.
And they'll be coming. We'll put them in ground zero. They've got sleeping bags and air mattresses
great.
And all that. We've got couches over there. So between now and Saturday night, make sure ground zero is up to speed. Up to the Wiley World.
I think that's really cool.
Well, it's just something that the Lord worked out. It's a God thing. God worked it out.
You're amazing yourself.
Well, they're struggling. They're a struggling group, and for 15 or so people, even if you figure 60, 70 bucks a night, you know.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh, it would be expensive.
If you had 15 people times 70 bucks, 7 to 5 is 35.
700 plus 350 is 1,050.
Yeah, that'd be they're going to be spending about 1,000 bucks or more.
Yeah.
And we'll save them that money.
Exactly.
And we'll feed them breakfast.
We're going to feed them.
We'll feed them breakfast on Sunday morning, and then they're going to sing for their food.
That's cool.
They're going to perform at our church Sunday
That's
morning.
That's great.
So put the word out.
I will put the word
it's
out.
It's called The Extreme Tour.
The Extreme Tour.
And they'll be here.
I may have to have you write that on the back of a business card.
No,
we'll
you're
do
writing
that
on
later.
The back of your mind.
The Extreme Tour.
Just remember, they're going to be extreme, sort of like you are.
Right.
And they're going to be the Extreme
Tour. I like that one, yeah.
We don't allow Peter to tour. We keep him here. You can't see it, folks. But there's a chain around his ankle. And he's got a chain around my neck
with a beautiful cross, too.
Amen. But we don't let Peter tour.
We
don't let him out yet.
I'm not let out yet. Yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
But the Extreme Tour will be here Saturday night.
That's cool.
Spend the night. They'll be here Sunday to perform.
Oh, yeah.
And they'll
great.
Spend the night Sunday night.
Oh, that's cool.
And they go to another performance. And then Monday morning, they're headed to Temecula.
Wow.
Down around Murrieta. So
wow.
Anyway, we're going to have guests for the weekend.
Well, I'm sure they're going to love it.
At Wiley World.
They're going to love it here. I'm going to let you go, Pastor.
All right.
I just want to say one thing.
Uh-oh, what?
That you are just awesome. I am lucky and blessed to have you in my life.
Well, thank
Not
you,
Not just
Peter.
As a pastor, But as a psychologist, a psychiatrist,
I refuse, a
bone breaker.
I refuse to admit that I'm a psychiatrist.
Now,
get out of here before I break some bones.
We only got an hour, Pete.
So get out of here.
Yes, sir.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. God does things, folks. That's what God did. God put that together. I didn't. God put that together. And the Extreme Tour, Brother Jaime is going to help me put together some promo on it, and we'll promo it. Today's only Tuesday. You see, Brother Jaime and I have, Wednesday and Thursday and Friday to promote it. We're going to promote the Extreme Tour. Jaime's going to put some stuff together from download. We got full permission from Isaac, their manager and leader. And so we're going to put some stuff up and let you see about Extreme Tour. And I'm going to go over there and try to hear them. I don't know if I will make it. He said they're supposed to go on at 9 p.m. over there at the Angel City Cafe. And but I have a meeting with the rich and the famous. I've got to go hobnobbing with the rich and famous. I've got a date with a beautiful blonde, and I'm going hobnobbing with the rich and famous. Actually, that's not really the total truth. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my food coordinator, Brenda Doherty, with me. She's the blonde, but I'm going to take her with me because she is going to be working with us and already is working with Brother Jaime and with Dran Reese and with other people in outreach. And we're going over to meet with Congressman Ed Royce. Congressman Ed Royce is the congressman that's fighting for the freedom of Andrew Tamaresis. Andrew Tamaresis. And when he's having a meeting with some people here in Orange County, and we have been invited. And so we're going to go, and we're going to be there and be a part of that meeting with Ed Royce. Now, that's on Saturday night. And Lord willing, I'm going to jump back on the freeway and run over here to the Angel City Cafe. That is a cafe version and an entertainment version of Wiley World. They don't sleep people, but they do take in poor people and homeless people. And they provide for them, and they allow groups to come to entertain them. And so the Angel City Cafe, we'll pull that down, and I've got to, I think it's, if I remember correctly, it's on Bellflower Boulevard, right over here close by us. So I might be able to be there by the time they're performing, and we're going to be looking at that and see if we can. I don't know, Brother Jaime, what your plans are Saturday night. But if you'd like to go with us to the Angel City Cafe, you're welcome to do so. And we might take some other people as well, anybody who wants to go. Jaime, have you ever been to the Angel City Cafe?
I haven't.
Over here in Bellflower. Now, you know Bellflower is an old city, been around a long time. And there was a bar and a nightclub and a honky-tonk, whatever you want to call it, right there on... Well, it was a honky-tonk, because there's some Southerners over there. And they haven't changed it much, I don't think. It still looks like a bar. It's right on the street. And when you go in, there's a big bar there, but there's no liquor. And they play loud music. And they have different groups come there and entertain. We had a fella, and this is another guy that I want to... It's about time I talked about him. I hadn't talked about him in a while. In fact, the matter is, let's just see what we can do here about maybe getting Mr. Aaron Schwartzbart. I would like to have him on the line with me, and I'm going to see if I can get him. Let's see. Aaron Schwartzbart. I'm going to see if I can get this guy and... let him know what's going on. Because the last time we were at the Angel City Cafe, we were there with Aaron Schwartzbart. Okay. He was the performer.
Huh. You're going to need to get tickets or anything like that?
No. Come on, Aaron, answer the phone, my brother. He has a video called Street Racer Music Video. When you get a chance, you ought to look at that. He has a Motor Gospel Ministry. Aaron Schwartzbart, this is your buddy, Wiley Drake. And we had a God thing happen today. Here during our live television show, a young man by the name of Isaac called me. And he said, they're going to be performing Saturday night at Angel City Cafe. I believe you have, performed there. We went there with you right over here on Bellflower Boulevard. Well, this group is called Extreme Tour, theextremetour.com. And the guy's name is Isaac, and they're going to be appearing at the Angel City Cafe. And they call me, someone called them and told them, there's about 15 of them, I think, and rather than pay expensive hotel bills, they needed some help. And so we're going to take in some performers. We're going to take them in Saturday night and Sunday night, and they'll be here at Wiley World. And we'd love to have Aaron Schwartzbart involved in this. So give me a call when you get a chance, brother. I need your help. You're used to meeting and working and helping these folk. And so God bless you. Hello? Is there an Oath Keepers? Is there an? You know, I don't know. Can you call me back and let me know? We're live on television right now. You're live on the show with me. I don't think our meeting is tonight, but if it is, let me know, will you?
Okay, then thank you.
I think it's on the 14th, but let me know. Call me back and let me know. All right. Let's see who's with us. Let me see who's on the line. Okay, we've still got Aaron. Aaron, I guess I wound up all your tape. I'm sorry. We're going to go off of Aaron. We are live, ladies and gentlemen. You never know what's going to happen at Wiley World. It's a God thing, though, I believe. Aaron Schwartzbart got saved. He was a bad boy. And his bad boy routine was not to perform, but his bad boy routine was to see how fast he could drive in an automobile and how fast he could go and so forth. Let's see who this is.
Okay.
Hello, this is Wiley. Who's there?
This is Wes Parker here. We're calling from the city council meeting in Long Beach.
Well, hang on just a minute, Wes.
Okay.
All right. You're calling in, and we thank you for calling. Where are you in Long Beach?
I am sitting here with Robert Bidstrom and a number of the California Crusaders, We the People Rising, and we are here in the Long Beach City Council meeting, and we are going to speak to them concerning the racist picture hanging in Senator Laura's office. For those who are listening to your show that don't know what the picture is, it's basically a picture of three police officers in their automobiles. Arizona police officers, and they pulled over a group of Hispanics in a car. One of the police officers saying, stopping the auto. Another says, I'm dying for some schnitzel. And another one of the Arizona police officers saying, Atun, we want to see your paper. And over to the right is a German Kaiser. Across his chest says, Arizona lawmaker. And he's saying, carry on, my good little soldiers. And all this is underneath a Welcome to Arizona sign that says, if you're brown, leave town.
Oh my God.
We are going to make public awareness to this, and we're going to be asking that Senator Lauren take down this picture, especially in a city such as Long Beach, which is an international city of trade, and also quite a large number of tourists come to this city. And this is very offensive to all people of German descendancy and anybody that wants to discourage racism.
Well, now, what city is this in, Long Beach?
Right, this is in Senator McConnell's You were at that rally. Like you covered that rally on your show.
Yes.
You did not go into his office with us, and you did not see this picture.
No, I was not able to get into the office because we were only there for a short period of time.
Right.
And,
right.
But what is the senator's name again? Spell it for us.
This is State Senator Ricardo Lara, L-A-R-A.
L-A-R-A. Okay, State Senator.
Right. And he was the one to introduce SB 1159, and that's why we were doing that rally at his office there on Atlantic Boulevard.
Yeah, and it's Senator Eduardo.
Ricardo.
Ricardo, I'm sorry.
Yeah, L-A-R-A.
Ricardo Lara.
Right.
And he was the one that was pushing 1159, and you're there to City Council to stand against this racism and so forth. Well, thank you for giving us a report. Ladies and gentlemen, the correspondent for the Wiley Drake Show, Wes Parker, there with my other correspondent, Robin.
Hey, Robin,
hi, Pastor Wiley.
Well, hello. I told him we can't go away without having a Robin report. Wes Parker did a great job, but Robin, give us your perspective on what's going on there in Long Beach. Why are you in Long Beach?
And they can see a photo of this wall hanging very racist on Senator Ricardo Lara's Long Beach office. So we're here at the city council meeting. We met with a reporter, and we're launching a campaign calling for the senator to remove this from his office wall. It's inappropriate, and we also would like a written apology from the senator.
Well, we certainly agree with you and hope that... that will take place, and we thank you all for being there. And what we're going to do is I'm going to see if I can pull. Now, if I go to We the People Rising, is that where I need to go?
WeThePeopleRising.com.
Okay.
Then scroll down a few stories, and you will see the video we took, as well as you will see a copy of the wall hanging. You will see that it's very racist.
Okay, and this is also the place that you went in where they had this man that was dressed up like a woman.
This was the wall hangings in his district office in Long Beach, but what you're describing occurred in his Sacramento office.
Ah, okay.
Okay. It is the same senator, yes.
And I'm scrolling down here. I'm seeing you folks on the street, and I see a speaker there, but I don't see that picture yet, but I'm trying to find it. I'm seeing some of the people there that were standing against that, and Brother Robert Newman is there and some other great godly people.
Yeah, it's right in that neighborhood.
Okay.
Robert Newman is the one that narrates.
Oh, okay. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to describe this for you. Robin is our correspondent there on the ground in Long Beach. And this is a cartoon. This is a picture, a caricature, a cartoon of a place close to the border. And the sign says, "Welcome to Arizona." And it says, if you're brown, leave town. Now, I'd be in trouble if I went over there. I'm not brown, but my executive producer is brown.
Yeah.
And if we were over there, we would be in trouble. It says, if you're brown, leave town. And then it says, stopping, a little German there, stopping your auto. Stopping your auto. And then another... statement says, with a machine gun, with a guy with a gun in his hand, Achtung, vivant your papers. Achtung, vivant your papers. That's on the picture, folks. And then there's another one there that says, carry on, my good little soldiers. And it has a banner across the front of him, and that is, Ach, lawmakers. And so this is a cartoon, and it says one other thing. Let me see what else it says. It says I'm driving. I'm not sure.
I'm trying for some schnitzel.
Yeah, I'm looking for some schnitzel. And so, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very racist comic, if you will. But it ain't funny, folks. If you're brown, leave town, that ain't funny. Now, folks, y'all know that I'm against illegal aliens. I don't care what color they are, red, yellow, black, or white. But to say if you're brown, leave town, that's very, very inappropriate. Now, where is this picture hanging?
Well, as you said, it is framed, and it is displayed right as you walk in to his Long Beach district office. Completely inappropriate, completely offensive, and we made an initial request asking for him to remove the wall hanging. He will not remove it. It was still hanging when we checked 2 days ago. So we're here to make issue of it. We want to get some press coverage, and we want to see the senator do the right thing and remove this racist and offensive wall hanging.
Well, and it is Senator Ricardo Lara, L-A-R-A. And ladies and gentlemen, I would encourage you, as you hear, let's see, N-A-T-O-R-L-A-R. As you hear my correspondent, Wes Parker, and my correspondent, Robin giving us the report there, we thank them for that, and I want you to know that these folks are doing their job. And by the way, folks, if you want a phone number, this is Senator Ricardo Lara, who has this terrible picture up there. His state capitol office is 916-651-4033. But this particular office is the one there in Long Beach. Is that correct, on Atlantic Avenue?
Correct. That is the correct, that is the office, the Long Beach office.
Okay, folks, the Long Beach office is area code 562-256-7921. 562-256-7921. That's the Long Beach office, and that's the office where that picture is hanging?
Correct.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to go see that picture, I would encourage you to go by there and say, I want to see that picture. And the location of that office is at 6550 Miles Avenue, up on the second floor there in, Long Beach District Office is at 3939 Atlantic Avenue, Suite 107, and that's in Long Beach, California, 90807. His phone number there is 562-256-7921. Go by there and see that picture. And ladies and gentlemen, you have my phone number. I'll give it out again in a minute. But if you go there and look at that picture, I wish you'd call me up and say, hey, I went and saw the picture, and I don't think it's too bad. Or you go look at the picture and say, I saw the picture and I think it's terrible. Or you go and say, well, you know, whatever you want to say, go see the picture. But don't call me about the picture unless you've seen it. If you've seen it, you can go to the picture. In fact, if you want to see what the picture looks like, not the picture itself, but an internet version of it, if you will, on Robin and them's website, go to, well, give your website so they can find that, would you?
WeThePeopleRising.com.
Now, you got to scroll down several photographs, several pictures, and then you will come to one that's not a photograph. It's a cartoon, a drawn picture. And I would encourage you to look at that picture, and you tell me if it's not anti-German, and anti-Hispanic, and anti-immigrant, all three of those. And here is a man who is a senator. Ladies and gentlemen, I live in California and have now most of my life. All of my children were born here in California. I tease my children, all four of them, about being prune pickers because they were born in California. But we've lived in California all our life, and I want you to know, friends, as a California voter, as a neighbor to Ricardo Lara's office here in Buena Park, Mr. Lara, you owe me an apology. And Mr. Ricardo Lara, if you do not apologize to me, I will pray in imprecatory prayer against you. And if you don't know what that is, call me. I'll explain it to you from the Word of God. Ladies and gentlemen, you need to call Ricardo Lara, L-A-R-A, and let him know you think that's a terrible, terrible racist picture. And if you get a chance to go by and see it, go by and look at it. If not, go to Robin's website, WeThePeopleRising.com, and look at it there. And I want to say thank you to Robin for being on the Robin Report and Wes Parker. Anything else you guys want to tell us?
Thank you, and please, all of America, visit the website, make the phone call. We need to unite against wrongdoing such as this and stand together. Thank you, Pastor.
Well, thank you, Robin. And by the way, before you go, I believe we have another appointment tomorrow. Over around 10 o'clock on South Street and Gridley. Is that right?
Yes, right on the corner there.
And what are we going to be doing? I'm going to be doing the Wiley Drake Show. What are you guys going to be doing?
Well, we have a very wonderful candidate, Benjamin Campos, who is running for the congressional seat, currently occupied Congresswoman Linda Sanchez. And we are going to be there to support Benjamin Campos. It's a Secure the Border rally, and also support this wonderful candidate who we would like to see elected and sent to Washington, D.C.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's in the city. What city is that in? I'm sorry.
That's in Commerce.
In City of Commerce, okay. And it's on the corner.
Cerritos.
Cerritos, yeah.
Cerritos. Yes, sorry about that.
That's okay. It's in Cerritos. But, ladies and gentlemen, I know exactly where Gridley and South. In fact, South Street comes all the way from there all the way over here to Buena Park. And when it gets into Buena Park, the name of the street changes to Orangethorpe. So on Wednesday morning, I'm going to make a little trek down Orangethorpe until it becomes South Street, and I'm going to be there at South and Gridley in Cerritos, and we'll be there before 9 o'clock, but definitely by 9 o'clock, because that's when the Wiley Drake Show will be live on location. We'll be live on location. Now, this is not a protest. This is not a demonstration, except a positive one. This is where we're going to stand with what I believe we have found out in our research, that he is a godly man and would make a good politician for our state. And I said when I heard about it, anybody that would run against Sanchez gets my vote. And that's not a Mexican statement, folks. I'm talking about her record. I don't care what color she is. I don't care that she's a woman. She could be red, yellow, black, or white, male or female. I don't care. But I do care about her voting record, and I do care what she's done to damage California. And we need to undo that damage that Ms. Sanchez, and I use that term very loosely, but Ms. Sanchez has damaged California, and we need to get her out of there. And fact of the matter is, I'm going to tell you, folks, we need to get her out of there and get her out quick. And Mr. Campos is going to be running against her, and he has my endorsement, my personal endorsement from Wiley Drake, Pastor Wiley Drake. He has my personal endorsement as he runs there for office against Sanchez. and we'll be there with you on Wednesday morning. Robin, thank you so much. Tell Wes Parker thank you. And
thank you.
Y'all be careful and have a great evening. Yeah, thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Rockin' Robin. Rockin' Robin. My goodness, everywhere I go, I run into Rockin' Robin. We were over, where were we yesterday? We were in Pasadena.
We were in Brea, Pasadena.
We were in Brea. We did a thing with her in Brea. Then we went to Pasadena. We were over near the Rose Bowl. But we were there to protest the taking over of the San Gabriel Mountain by Choo-choo-ca-choo. Coo-coo-ca-choo. Coo-coo-ca-choo is the, I assume that's Chinese. I don't know. I'll just be putting my prejudice hat on a minute and say that I think Choo is a Chinese name. I don't know that. I'm just making an assumption. But I don't care whether she's Chinese, Japanese, American. I don't care what her nationality is. I don't care what her sex is. I don't care what her age is. But I do care that she said, I like what Miss Pelosi said. Pelosi said, Chinese. We're not going to vote. They didn't want to vote on the Obama thing until they read it, but Nancy Pelosi said, no, we're going to vote on it. We'll vote on it and pass it, and we'll read it later. Well, now, folks, that's history. But now there's some new history developing. Coo-coo-ca-choo has brought up a bill to take over the San Gabriel Mountains and turn it over to the federal government. And as I said the other day, you want to know what the federal government does to something, go down to your local post office. Now, I have some friends that work at the post office, and I hope they won't get too mad at me. But I'll tell you something, folks. If you want to see poor management and wasteful management and terrible management, go to your local post office. We have two post offices right here near us, and the reason I know that is because the one down here, when you go down there to buy a book of stamps, now I'm the last of the big spenders, you know, I go and buy a whole book of stamps at one time. And I go in there and I wait in line and I wait in line and I wait in line and I get a cup of coffee and I wait in line and they're taking forever just to sell me a book of stamps. Folks, that's the most inept bunch in the history of our nation, the United States Post Office. You know why? Because they're run by the federal government. That's why. You want to know what the San Gabriel Mountain Monument District would be like? Go down to the post office. We talked to some young ladies and young men, as well as some old folks yesterday there in Pasadena, saying, we don't want them to change our way of life. We don't want the federal government coming in here, like the Bureau of Land Management did over in a neighboring state, and kill people's cows and threaten to kill people. That's your government, ladies and gentlemen, the Bureau of Land Management. The Bureau of Land Management is a committee. They do not have legal authority to carry weapons. They do not have legal authority to do that, and yet they were on the ground with long guns and handguns and threatening to shoot and kill people if they didn't get out of their way. Well, folks, that's your federal government. That's your federal government. Your federal government, ladies and gentlemen, in action. We were there with Robin and others. Rockin' Robin was on the duty there in Pasadena. She's now over in Long Beach. Rockin' Robin over in Long Beach with Wes Parker, our other correspondent. By the way, folks, let me just tell you, how would you like to be able to tell your friends that you are now a international television and radio network correspondent? An international television and radio network correspondent. There's only one requirement that we have. You have to be a Bible believer. If you don't believe the Bible, don't call me. Don't call me and say, I want to be your correspondent. The reason Robin is my correspondent is not because she's such a pretty girl, although that doesn't discourage me. But she is a correspondent for the Wiley Drake Show. You know why? Because she's a lot like me. She's a Bible thumper. She's a Bible thumper. She believes in the Bible when it comes to politics. And so, in spite of the fact that she is gorgeous, she is not my correspondent because of that. She's a correspondent because she believes the Bible. And Wes Parker, he's a handsome dude and a good-looking fellow, but that's not why he's my correspondent. He can be ugly as sin, but he's my correspondent because he, too, is another one of those that is a Bible thumper. And fact of the matter is, ladies and gentlemen, I just got the title for tonight's show. Bible Thumpers. Bible Thumpers. That's the name of the show tonight. If you want to come back and see it later, we've only got about 4 minutes left to go. But I want to remind you that we're going to have a great week ahead of us. We're going to have Extreme Tour. They're going to come in, and they're going to be with us on Saturday night and Sunday night. They're going to be here at Wiley World. We're going to feed them good. We're going to sleep them good. And then we're going to send them on their way to Temecula down near Murrieta, where Rockin' Robin made a lot of reports down there as well. And fact of the matter is, Rockin' Robin went to Murrieta and took the Border Patrol tour. She took the Border Patrol group. She went on the border with those people and stopped illegal immigrants from bringing in sickness to this nation. Ladies and gentlemen, we only have about 3 minutes left. I want to remind you of something that's coming up this Sunday. I got one more advertisement I've got to do quickly before we go off. I want to encourage you to go on the web when you hang up, when you get off the air. Go to I Pledge Sunday. I Pledge Sunday 2014.com. I Pledge Sunday. Support I Pledge Sunday. That's coming up on the 12th. We'll have a great meeting here. We want you to come to our church on Sunday afternoon at 4 p.m. We'll be here showing you speakers from all over the country. We're going to have speakers here from Washington, D.C. We're going to have people like David Barton will be speaking. We're going to have Pastor Jim Garlow from down in San Diego, Tony Perkins from Washington, D.C., and Sandy Rios, great correspondent for one of my favorite radio stations, and that is American Family Radio. Sandy Rios is a correspondent, and by the way, she has the same problem that Robin has. She is one gorgeous lady. But that's not why Don Wildman and Tim Wildman made her a correspondent, I assure you. I know those men. I used to work for them. I used to work for Don Wildman. And I know for a fact that they would not hire her because she was good looking. They would hire her because she's a good correspondent. And one other guy we're going to have there, my buddy, my fellow Southern Baptist preacher, the Right Reverend Rick Scarborough, wrote a book called Enough is Enough when they tried to take over his daughter's high school there in Texas. And he also now has a group called Vision America. So those speakers are going to be a part of I Pledge Sunday. That's this Sunday, folks. That's this coming Sunday on the 14th here. And I believe it's the 14th. No, I'm sorry, it's the 12th. Excuse me. The 12th. We're having I Pledge Sunday 2014. You want to find out more about it? Go to ipledgesunday2014.com. Folks, it's time for us to get out of here and say goodnight to Crusade Radio. And I'm going to say goodnight to them first. And I think maybe, no, they haven't said goodnight yet. So goodnight, Crusade Radio. Remember, do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God. And there goes Crusade Radio. And now we're going to go off on the telephonic prayer list, and we're going to hang that one up, and we're dead on that. Now, we're still live on the air. Is that right?
Right. I'm going to put on the clip. It's a 1.5-minute clip.
All right. Extreme. Do that. Can I see it? Will I be able to see it?
I'm not sure.
Okay, that's okay.
I'll
see it later.
All right. So
the Extreme Tour, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. I'll see it this way.
And Brother Jaime is going to try to put that up. I see something coming up. XT Films is coming up. And this year, folks, hey, there they are, dragging their suitcase down the street. They're going to drag their suitcase over here to Wiley World and spend the night with us Saturday night. And they're going to be at Wiley World. There they are set up. They're going to be set up to travel to unfamiliar places. Man, they've been sweating. Isaac is going to be here, and I'm hoping that Aaron Schwartzbart will be with us. And you see, they're a great singer, skateboarder, and Aaron and them are extreme as well. They do street racer music video. The love of God, they talk about, they dance about it, they sing about it, and they're going to be with us Saturday night. And Sunday morning and Sunday Isaac will be here, and they're going to be here with us over the weekend. To God be the glory. Great things. God put this together, folks. I didn't do this. God put it together. Now, I'm back with you, but I'm going to say it's time for me to get out of here. Good night. God bless you, and we'll see you tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning, folks, we'll be live on location in Cerritos, California, at South and Gridley. Come join us. We'll be there live on the air. God bless you, and have a great, great evening. Remember, do justice, love mercy, and walk with God.